There's a lot of attention on large language models, or LLMs, and rightfully so. These AI models have proven to be remarkable at performing a multitude of AI tasks. The question is, how large is large? Or better yet, is larger always better? To answer that question, we will explore attributes of LLMs. And in the process, I might even convince you that there's an alternative that is better with less. But we'll take a detour, and we'll look at a very unlikely area for an example. Dinosaurs. Dinosaurs were large and had huge scale, and one would expect that was sufficient to ensure they did not become extinct. However, the characteristics of large and huge scale was not sufficient to prevent the extinction. Contrast that with ants. Ants are smaller, yet they continue to thrive. And I would point to two things: specialization and efficiency. Now, I realize and I can see you at home saying, well, Kip, that is a very poor analogy, but stick with me and you'll see where I'm headed. Let's answer the question, what is the relationship between this poor analogy and LLMs? I'll answer that by looking at three attributes of LLMs. We'll start with cost. When we talk of cost, there are different components or elements to this. There's the cost of the consumption of the energy used to train the models, the cost of compute, the cost of inferencing. There's also the cost of the carbon that is emitted when LLMs are in use. But for simplicity, I will examine two models and compare them in terms of energy consumption to train these models. So we'll start with cost, as I said. We'll look at a large model at 175 billion parameters and a smaller model at 13 billion parameters. Now, the energy consumed to train the larger model was 284,000 kilowatt hours. And for the smaller model, it was 153,000 kilowatt hours. Now, you're probably saying, Kip, this is logical. Why do we even need to talk about it? Well, the reason I'm bringing it up is to make sure we are clear, cost is always a consideration. In fact, I'll go further and point out that it takes about a tenth of GPU hours to train the smaller model relative to the larger model. The next attribute that I want us to look at is that of latency. And for that, once again, we'll look at two models and we'll compare the performance of the two. We'll start with a 70 billion parameter for the larger model, and we'll compare it to a 13 billion parameter model for the smaller one. I should add, this model is trained on enterprise domain-specific data. Now, when a test was performed comparing these two models, the smaller model performed 3 times faster than the larger model. And I think we can appreciate that because of the variable or the scale of the data, obviously the response time for the larger model would be slower than that of the smaller model. And you may come back and say, well, Kip, I don't care about cost necessarily, or I don't necessarily care as much about the latency. What is important to me is the performance. Well, let us look at accuracy. And again, we'll compare the two models, the 13 billion parameter model and the 70 billion parameter model. So these two models were tested on financial services tasks. And they were tested on 11 tasks on sentiment analysis, classification, question and answering, summarization, a number of generative AI tasks. And when the results came out, this is how they fared. The 70 billion parameter model had 0.59 result in terms of accuracy. The 13 billion parameter model had 0.57. Now, one would expect that the larger model would perform significantly better than the smaller model. But because this model was trained on domain data specific to this industry, its performance is relatively similar to that of the larger model. I think you begin to get the picture that I'm trying to paint for you. Domain-specific models are a consideration when thinking through what LLM should I use. There is no question about the performance of LLMs, generally speaking, in terms of the different tasks that they do. As I mentioned at the beginning, they are superb. However, I would like to put out for your consideration that domain-specific models, because of two things I mentioned earlier on, specialization and efficiency, should be a consideration. So let's go back to the question we started off earlier. Is larger always better? Not necessarily. The question then becomes, how do I choose which model? Or should I choose a larger model? My answer will be, it depends. It depends on the use case that you need it for. What I want you to take away from this, though, is in certain scenarios, in certain use cases, domain-specific models will be a better alternative. And here's why. As we have seen through the examination we performed, it was equal or comparable to the larger model in terms of the accuracy. It performed better in terms of the latency, and it cost much less from a cost perspective. So when you take these three attributes into consideration, and this is just an example, there are more attributes you can look at, domain-specific models should be a consideration in terms of the LLMs that you use at your organization. And with that, I thank you. If you liked this video and want to see more like it, please like and subscribe. If you have questions, please drop them in the comments below.